I don't know what it means to be in a society where our myths are incapable of resolving themselves, where we have these heroes that never do the things that, that actual human beings do, or that traditional heroes have done. They don't grow old, they don't plan anything, they don't struggle in any significant way.
In a world where failing gets you a participation trophy and mediocrity is somehow universally praised by critics, we come to Kevin Smith. Kevin Smith's Masters of the Universe was released universally hated by fans and praised by critics, which seems to be how 99% of the media is nowadays. There's a massive disconnect between actual fans of something and the agenda-pushing critics. I'm going to be spoiling some things here so you can skip my video, or you can watch and save yourself some wasted time on whatever the show was supposed to be. If you recall the first season of Masters of the Universe, they killed off He-Man and focused the entire plot on a woman with a bad attitude who for some reason looks more masculine than Macho Man Randy Savage, who also, by the way, hates He-Man, can work together with her friend she obviously is frothing at the loins for, to reluctantly bring back He-Man later in season 2. Yes, this has the writing creativity as a Wall Street feminist that works on something like High Guardian Spice. God, I'm not even two paragraphs into the script and I already want to drink myself into a coma. After the universal backlash Kevin Smith received after killing off He-Man, he basically referred to the fans as toxic bile at the release of season 2, saying there was less negativity. Well, Kevin, the reason why there was less negativity is because all the fans left. Season 1 was hyped for original fans who have been waiting, which is why Masters of the Universe Season 1 was on Netflix's top 10 most watched spot, and falling off after a week. Never to return again during Season 2, the people who grew up and wanted more He-Man were spit on. You took an established franchise and basically put your spin on it and killed off the most beloved character in the first season and made the show completely about someone else. And in season 2, basically made it so Evil Lynn was only evil because of how she was treated by Skeletor. This has the same moronic logic Cruella De Vil had on Disney. You know, the evil lady from 101 Dalmatians that wanted to skin dogs and make coats? Well, in the live-action remake, she's only skinning dogs because a man treated her badly and made her that way. Honestly, it's so tiring seeing everything Hollywood makes framed as evil woman only evil because men worse, or every dude character turns out to be a useless moron, as seen by recent Star Wars films. This is why I watch YouTube for entertainment or documentaries, because anything Hollywood has made in the last 5 years has literally killed my brain cells. But forgive me, I'm getting off topic. That's not true. I did buy the Sonic movie and I liked that, and I also like Rob Zombie's 31, but that's literally the only movies I've bought in like 5 years. Actually, if we're gonna be honest with ourselves, why in God's name is He-Man even a part of Masters of the Universe? Teela can do whatever He-Man can do plus more, because in today's society, being a virtue signaling blogger is the only requirement you need on a resume to be hired as a writing staff apparently. Even evil female characters have to be all good in the end. I honestly feel like the only reason Skeletor and He-Man are in the series is to be used as cannon fodder ragdolls, the same way Luke Skywalker was treated in The Last Jedi.
Oh my!
I should probably be polite in the rest of this video. After all, we do know Kevin Smith is prone to crying. Probably asking, Dark, what is the point of this video? Well, I'm not much of a comic book guy, but I do like movies, and what I'm seeing is a giant circle of pretentiousness. All of our heroes have to be overpowered Mary Sues, the guys have to be stupid as shit and used as ragdolls like the main villain in Captain Marvel. I didn't realize the dude being thrown around was the main villain the whole time. I thought to be an antagonist or a main villain, you had to pose some kind of threat, which in turn would motivate the hero to overcome obstacles and challenges to grow stronger to defeat said antagonist or villain. Since when are heroes strong outside the gate and the villain throughout the whole movie stands no chance since the beginning? That seems like lazy and crap writing to me. But anyway, there seems to be a lack of an accountability of shit writing from Hollywood. I don't know if these people are creatively bankrupt or if they've written so many movies they cannot come up with anything original anymore. But one thing we can be sure on is that when it doesn't do well, they'll blame the fans as right-wing trolls for whatever fucking reason. I heard a rumor that Demon Slayer apparently outsold the entirety of the American comic book industry, and honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if that was true, but it's a little more complicated than that after I checked a bunch of fact-checking sources, and I went to the original website where the article was posted. I scrolled down to the comments, and it's just a bunch of people arguing with each other with homophobic slurs. Anybody who takes the internet that seriously really needs help. Honestly, if we could go back to writing heroes you could relate to, people who had to go through some kind of tragedy or struggle and overcome obstacles to get to where they want to be, to exact revenge or defeat the antagonist, that would be great. Because antagonists being super fucking weak at the beginning, posing no threat throughout the whole thing, is awful and lazy. I think Kevin Smith is a good example to showcase what's wrong with superheroes and villains in today's society, which I find really ironic because he claims to be a massive fan of comics and superheroes. So you'd think he'd at least understand how they're supposed to be written. I don't know. That's just my opinions on everything. And that's just all I wanted to get off my chest for today. I hope you liked the video, and you know, if you like this video, go ahead and like it. If you dislike it, well, dislikes don't really mean much anymore, sadly. But dislike it anyway, and I will see you in the next one, and as always, I hope you have a beautiful day.
I'm the weirdo, because I'm sitting in the tree going...